Dear viewers, Drishti IAS welcomes you to the new series of Simplified. Today's topic of discussion is important constitutional amendments. Under this topic, the dimensions we are going to cover are introduction, procedure for amendment as laid down in Article 368, Part 20, and important amendments. So let's begin with the introduction first. Like any other written constitution in the world, the Constitution of India also provides for its amendment in order to adjust itself according to the changing conditions and needs. Article 368 in Part 20 of the Constitution deals with the powers of Parliament to amend the Constitution and its procedure. It states that the Parliament may amend the Constitution by way of addition, variation, or repeal of any provision in accordance with the procedure laid down for the purpose. However, the Parliament cannot amend those provisions which form the basic structure of the Constitution. This was ruled by the Supreme Court in the Keshavananda Bharati case, 1973. Now let's discuss about the procedure for amendment as laid down in Article 368, Part 20. Amendment of the Constitution can be initiated only by the introduction of a bill in either of the House and not in the state legislatures. The bill can be introduced either by a minister or by a private member and does not require prior permission of the President. The bill must be passed in each House by a special majority. Each House must pass the bill separately. In case of a disagreement between the two Houses, there is no provision for holding a joint sitting of the two Houses. If the bill seeks to amend the federal provisions of the Constitution, it must also be ratified by the state legislatures of half of the states by a simple majority. After duly passed by both houses and ratified by the state legislatures, the bill is presented to the President for assent. The President must give his assent. He can neither withhold his assent to the bill nor return the bill for reconsideration of the Parliament. After the President's assent, the bill becomes an Act, CAA. Now let's discuss about the important constitutional amendments. First Amendment Act, 1951. Reasons were to remove certain practical difficulties created by the court's decision in several cases, the Kameshwar Singh case, Romesh Thapar case, etc. Issues involved in the cases included freedom of speech, acquisition of the zamindari land, state monopoly of trade, etc. Amendments made were, it empowered the state to make special provisions for the advancement of socially and economically backward classes, provided for the saving of laws, providing for acquisition of estates, etc. Added 9th schedule to protect the land reforms and other laws included in it from the judicial review. After Article 31, Articles 31A and 31B were inserted. Added 3 more grounds of restrictions on freedom of speech and expression, public order, friendly relations with foreign states, and incitement to an offense. Also, it made the restrictions reasonable and thus justiciable in nature. Provided that state trading and nationalization of any trade or business by the state is not to be invalid on the ground of violation of right to trade or business. Next is 4th Amendment Act, 1955. Amendments were, it made the scale of compensation given in lieu of compulsory acquisition of private property beyond the scrutiny of courts. Authorized the state to nationalize any trade, included some more acts in the 9th schedule, and extended the scope of Article 31A, that is, savings of laws. Next is 7th Amendment Act, 1956. Amendments were to implement the recommendations of the State Reorganization Committee and to implement the State Reorganization Act, 1956. Amendments were 2nd and 7th schedules were amended. Abolished the existing classification of states into 4 categories, that is, Part A, Part B, Part C and Part D states and reorganized them into 14 states and 6 union territories. Extended the jurisdiction of high courts to union territories. Provided for the establishment of a common high court for two or more states and provided for the appointment of additional and acting judges of the high court. Next is 9th Amendment Act 1960. Reasons were, after the Nehru-Noon Agreement was signed between India and Pakistan to divide the territory of Berubadi Union, the government of West Bengal opposed it. After this union referred the matter to Supreme Court, which held that the power of Parliament to diminish the area of a state under Article 3 does not cover cession of Indian territory to a foreign country. Hence, Indian territory can be ceded to a foreign state only by amending the Constitution under Article 368. Consequently, the 9th Constitutional Amendment Act 1960 was enacted. Amendments made were, it facilitated the cession of the Indian territory to Berubadi Union, that is located in West Bengal, to Pakistan as provided in the Indo-Pakistan Agreement 1958. Next is 10th Amendment Act 1961, and the amendments made were incorporation of Dadra, Nagar and Haveli as a union territory consequent to acquisition from Portugal. Next is 11th Amendment Act 1961, and the amendments were, it changed the procedure of election of the Vice President by providing for an electoral college instead of a joint meeting of the two houses of the Parliament. Provided that the election of the President or Vice President cannot be challenged on the ground of any vacancy in the appropriate electoral college. 12th Amendment Act 1962. In this, amendments made were incorporated Goa, Daman and Diu in the Indian Union. 13th Amendment Act 1962. Amendments made were, it gave the status of a state to Nagaland and made special provisions for it. Next is 14th Amendment Act 1962. In this, amendments were, it incorporated Puducherry in the Indian Union and provided for the creation of legislators and council of ministers for the union territories of Himachal Pradesh, Manipur, Tripura, Goa, Daman and Diu and Puducherry. 17th Amendment Act 1964. Amendments were, prohibited the acquisition of land under personal cultivation unless the market value of the land is paid as compensation, and included 44 more acts in the 9th schedule. Next is 18th Amendment Act 1966. Amendments were, it made it clear that a power of Parliament to form a new state also includes a power to form a new state or union territory by uniting a part of a state or a union territory to another state or union territory. It created new states, namely Punjab and Haryana. 21st Amendment Act 1967. Amendments included Sindhi as the 15th language in the 8th schedule. Next is 24th Amendment Act 1971. Reasons were, it was brought in response to the Golaknath ruling 1967 of the Supreme Court, which held that the Parliament does not have the power to take away any fundamental rights through amendment to the Constitution. Amendments were, it affirmed the power of Parliament to amend any part of the Constitution, including fundamental rights by amending Article 13 and 368, and made it compulsory for the President to give his assent to a constitutional amendment bill. Next is 25th Amendment Act 1971, and the amendments were, it curtailed the fundamental right to property and provided that any law made to give effect to the directive principles contained in Article 39B or C cannot be challenged on the ground of violation of the rights guaranteed by Articles 14, 19 and 31. 26th Amendment Act 1971. Amendments were, it abolished the privy purses and privileges of the former rulers of princely states. 31st Amendment Act 1973. Reasons, an increase in the population of India revealed in the census of 1971. Amendments included that it increased the number of Lok Sabha seats from 525 to 545. 33rd Amendment Act 1974. It amended Articles 101 and 190 and provided that the resignation of the members of Parliament and the state legislators may be accepted by the Speaker or Chairman only if he is satisfied that the resignation is voluntary or genuine. 35th Amendment Act. Amendments were that it terminated the protectorate status of Sikkim and conferred the status of an associate state of the Indian Union. The 10th schedule was added, laying down the terms and conditions of association of Sikkim with the Indian Union. 36th Amendment Act, 1975. Amendments included that it made Sikkim a full-fledged state of the Indian Union and omitted the 10th schedule. 38th Amendment Act, 1975. Amendments included, it made the declaration of emergency by the President non-justiciable, made the promulgation of ordinances by the President, governors and administrators of Union territories non-justiciable, and empowered the President to declare different proclamations of national emergency on different grounds simultaneously. 42nd Amendment Act, 1976. Amendments were, it added three new words, that is, socialist, secular and integrity in the preamble. Added fundamental duties by the citizens, new part 4A. It made the President bound by the advice of the Cabinet. Provided for administrative tribunals and tribunals for other matters, that added part 14A. Froze the states in the Lok Sabha and the state legislative assemblies on the basis of 1971 census till 2001. Population controlling measure. It made the constitutional amendments beyond judicial scrutiny. Curtailed the power of judicial review and writ jurisdiction of the Supreme Court and High Courts. Raised the tenure of Lok Sabha and state legislative assemblies from 5 to 6 years. Provided that the laws made for the implementation of directive principles cannot be declared invalid by the courts on the ground of violation of some fundamental right. Empowered the Parliament to make laws to deal with anti-national activities, and such laws are to take precedence over fundamental rights. It added three new directive principles, that is, equal justice and free legal aid, the participation of workers in the management of industries, and protection of the environment, forests, and wildlife. It facilitated the proclamation of national emergency in a part of the territory of India. Extended the one-time duration of the President's rule in a state from 6 months to 1 year. Empowered the center to deploy its armed forces in any state to deal with a grave situation of law and order. Shifted 5 subjects from the state list to the concurrent list. They are education, forest, protection of wild animals and birds, weights and measures and administration of justice, constitution and organization of all courts, except the Supreme Court and the High Court. Provided for the creation of the All India Judicial Service and shortened the procedure for disciplinary action by taking away right of a civil servant to make representation at the second stage after the inquiry, that is on the penalty proposed. 43rd Amendment Act, 1977. Amendments were, it restored the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court and the High Courts in respect of judicial review and issue of writs, and deprived the Parliament of its special powers to make laws to deal with anti-national activities. 44th Amendment Act, 1978. Amendments included, it restored the original term of the Lok Sabha and the state legislative assemblies, that is, 5 years. Restored the provisions with regard to the quorum in the Parliament and state legislatures. Omitted the reference to the British House of Commons in the provisions pertaining to parliamentary privileges. Gave constitutional protection to publication in a newspaper of true reports of the proceedings of the Parliament and the state legislatures. Empowered the President to send back once the advice of the Cabinet for reconsideration. But the reconsidered advice is to be binding on the President. Deleted the provision which made the satisfaction of the President, Governor and administrators final in issuing ordinances. Restored some of the powers of the Supreme Court and High Courts. Replaced the term internal disturbance by armed rebellion in respect of national emergency. made the president declare a national emergency only on the written recommendation of the cabinet, made certain procedural safeguards with respect to a national emergency and president's rule, deleted the right to property from the list of fundamental rights and made it only a legal right, provided that the fundamental rights guaranteed by Articles 20 and 21 cannot be suspended during a national emergency, and omitted the provisions which took away the power of the court to decide the election disputes of the President, the Vice President, the Prime Minister and the Speaker of the Lok Sabha. 50th Amendment Act 1984. Amendments included, it empowered the Parliament to restrict the fundamental rights of persons employed in intelligence organizations and telecommunication systems set up for the armed forces or intelligence organizations. 52nd Amendment Act 1985. Reasons were to stop defection and the politics of Aaya Ram Gaya Ram. Amendments were, it provided for the disqualification of members of the Parliament and state legislators on the ground of defection and added a new 10th schedule containing the details in this regard. 61st Amendment Act 1989. Amendments were, it reduced the voting age from 21 years to 18 years for the Lok Sabha and State Legislative Assembly election. 65th Amendment Act 1990. It provided for the establishment of a multi-member national commission for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes in the place of a special officer for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. 69th Amendment Act 1991. Amendments were, it accorded a special status to the Union Territory of Delhi by designing it as the National Capital Territory of Delhi. And the amendment also provided for the creation of a 70-member Legislative Assembly and a 7-member Council of Ministers for Delhi. 73rd Amendment Act 1992. Amendment was, it granted constitutional status and protection to the Panchayati Raj institutions. For this purpose, the amendment has added a new Part 9 entitled as the Panchayats and a new 11th schedule containing 29 functional items of the Panchayats. 74th Amendment Act 1992. In this amendment was, it granted a constitutional status and protection to the urban local bodies. For this purpose, the amendment has added a new Part 9A entitled the Municipalities and a new 12th schedule containing 18 functional items of the municipalities. 81st Amendment Act 2000. Amendments were, it empowered the state to consider the unfilled reserved vacancies of a year as a separate class of vacancies to be filled up in any succeeding year or years. Such case of vacancies is not to be combined with the vacancies of the year in which they are being filled up to determine the ceiling of 50% reservation on total number of vacancies of that year. In brief, this amendment ended the 50% ceiling on reservation in backlog vacancies. 84th Amendment Act 2001. Amendments were, it extended the ban on the readjustment of seats in the Lok Sabha and the state legislative assemblies for another 25 years, that is up to 2026, with the same objective of encouraging population limiting measures. In other words, the number of seats in the Lok Sabha and the assemblies are to remain the same till 2026. And it also provided for the readjustment and rationalization of territorial constituencies in the states on the basis of the population figures of 1991 census. 86th Amendment Act 2002. Amendments were, it made elementary education a fundamental right under the Article 21A. It changed the subject matter of Article 45 in directive principles and added a new fundamental duty under Article 51A. 87th Amendment Act 2003. Amendments were, it provided for the readjustment and rationalization of territorial constituencies in the states on the basis of the population figures of 2001 census and not 1991 census, as provided earlier by the 84th Amendment Act of 2001. 89th Amendment Act 2003. Amendments were, it bifurcated the erstwhile combined National Commission for Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes into two separate bodies, namely National Commission for Scheduled Castes, Article 338, and National Commission for Scheduled Tribes, that is Article 338A. 91st Amendment Act 2003. Amendments were, the total number of ministers, including the Prime Minister, in the Central Council of Ministers shall not exceed 50% of the total strength of Lok Sabha. A member of either House of Parliament belonging to any political party who is disqualified on the ground of defection shall also be disqualified to be appointed as a minister. The total number of ministers, including the Chief Minister, in the Council of Ministers in a state shall not exceed 50% of the total strength of the Legislative Assembly of that state. But the number of ministers, including the Chief Minister, in a state shall not be less than 12. A member of either house of a state legislature belonging to any political party who is disqualified on the ground of defection shall also be disqualified to be appointed as a minister. A member of either House of Parliament or either House of a state legislature belonging to any political party who is disqualified on the ground of defection shall also be disqualified to hold any remunerative political post. And the provision of the 10th schedule, that is anti-defection law, pertaining to exemption from disqualification in case of split by 1/3 members of the legislature party has been deleted. It means that the defectors have no more protection on grounds of splits. 92nd Amendment Act 2003. Amendments were, it included four more languages in the 8th schedule. They are Bodo, Dogri or Dongri, Maithili and Santhali. With this, the total number of constitutionally recognized languages increased to 22. 93rd Amendment Act 2005. Amendments were, it empowered the state to make special provisions for the socially and educationally backward classes or the scheduled caste or the scheduled tribes in educational institutions, including private educational institutions, whether aided or unaided by the state, except the minority educational institutions, clause 5 in Article 15. 97th Amendment Act 2011. Amendments were, it gave constitutional status and protection to cooperative societies. It made the following three changes in the constitution. It made the right to form cooperative societies a fundamental right in Article 19. It included a new directive principle of state policy on the promotion of cooperative societies. And it added a new part 9B in the constitution, which is entitled the Cooperative Societies. 99th Amendment Act 2040. Amendments were, it replaced the collegium system of appointing judges to the Supreme Court and High Courts with a new body called the NJAC, that is National Judicial Appointments Commission. However, in 2015, the Supreme Court declared this amendment act as unconstitutional and void. Consequently, the earlier collegium system became operative again. 100th Amendment Act 2014. Amendments were, it gave effect to the acquiring of certain territories by India and transfer of certain other territories to Bangladesh through the exchange of enclaves and retention of adverse possessions in pursuance of the Land Boundary Agreement of 1974 and its Protocol of 2011. For this purpose, this Amendment Act amended the provisions relating to the territories of four states, that is Assam, West Bengal, Meghalaya and Tripura, in the first schedule of the Constitution. 101st Amendment Act 2017. Amendments were, introduction of the Goods and Services Tax. Goods and Services Tax, that is GST, is an indirect tax or consumption tax used in India on the supply of goods and services. It is comprehensive, multi-stage, destination-based tax. Comprehensive because it has subsumed almost all the indirect taxes except a few state taxes. 102nd Amendment Act 2018. Amendments were, Constitutional status was provided to the National Commission for Backward Classes under India's Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Article 338B into the Constitution, after Articles 338 and 338A, which deal with the National Commission for Scheduled Caste, that is SC, and National Commission for Scheduled Tribes, that is ST, respectively. 103rd Amendment Act 2019. Amendments were: it introduced reservations for economic weaker section for the first time in independent India. Amendment in Article 16 allows a 10% reservation to EWS in public employment. Lastly, let's discuss about the 104th Amendment Act 2020. Amendments were: it extended the deadline for the cessation of seats for SCs and STs in the Lok Sabha and state assemblies from 70 years to 80 years, and removed the reserved seats for the Anglo-Indian community in the Lok Sabha and state assemblies. So that's all for today. Stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks for watching.